Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really great sublimation tutorial. This time, we're going to show you some new and creative ways to add photos to your sublimation prints.
All right, guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio. And, you know, of course, this is always like my favorite designing program. I really love using it because I was already so familiar with it, starting with the Silhouette Cameo. But I still hold to my common point in these videos that a lot of these techniques or a lot of these tools can be used in other software. So hopefully, even if you don't use Silhouette Studio, you'll be able to, you know, gain some inspiration to use with your own projects in whatever software you choose. Now, the first thing that I'm going to do is go ahead and import some of the photos that I'm going to work with today. So I've just opened a File Explorer menu here, File Explorer panel, and I can simply drag and drop these photos over into the software. Now, they do come in rather large, and the only thing you have to watch for is to make sure that you don't drag and drop them on top of each other, because they will replace each other if you do that. So you can either move your box around or move your photos around on your designing area. Now, of course, you don't have to have all these photos, but I just wanted to show you that you can definitely go ahead and, if you're working with a design that you're going to use multiple photos for, just go ahead and bring those in, and then you can leave those over here in your designing area. Now, the first thing to do, let's go ahead and just talk about the power of cropping a photo. Okay, because this is a photo, you know, leave it to my husband. He is not going to take photos that I would take, right? But a lot of times he's the one that's there, especially with the sports. So I have to rely on him to do this. Now, there's a couple things that you can do. You can use your knife tool to cut the image off, the part that you don't want. The part that I like to do is I like to just draw a box around the part of the photo that I do want to keep. So in this case, the best that I can do with this photo is to just draw it and try to keep the ugliness out of the photo. So if I select both of these, open my modify panel and choose crop, it will crop it down into what I deem a more acceptable photo. Now, is it perfect? No, of course not. But I think if you put them side by side, you can definitely see that there is a pretty big difference. Okay, so let's get rid of that one. So this one will tentatively be a keeper. And let's talk about, all right, so this is a really cute photo. And here, this is the one I want. And I'll tell you why. You know, boys will be boys to some extent in some circumstances. And what seems to hold true with mine is that the older they get, they do not want to take pictures with their sister. I know, shocking, very shocking. What I'm going to do, now I'm using Flexi Shapes. Flexi Shapes are only available if you have upgraded to the Designer Edition Plus or Business Edition of Silhouette Studio. But you can bring in your own heart SVG or any other shape. This time I'm going to use a heart, and I am going to use the heart to frame this photo. Now I have to convert to path to lock it into shape because it is a Flexi Shape. But I'm going to surround these two here, and maybe for just a little bit, I can pretend that, you know, they still like each other. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. I can select these two, open my modify panel, and crop. So really cute, and that takes the edge off. You know, not only am I working my magic to be able to crop it down, and it gives it a cute shape, but it takes out all of that unnecessary, the drama on the back and the sides. Okay, so another really cute one. Now, another thing that we can do, and this photo is probably my favorite one, and while it does need to be cropped down, and we can go ahead and take care of that, let me show you another way. If you double click, it will open your point editing, and you can then select multiple points by using your drag box. And on my keyboard, I'm going to choose shift and down, and it will rein in the excess of this photo. But sometimes I like doing that because I feel like maybe I have a little bit more flexibility with it. And then once I click off, it'll just stay just like that. Now, one thing that I can do is I can frame this photo. What I mean by that is I can draw a border just along the outside. I can also use my offset tool for this. Sometimes the offset is easier to use, but I can send that to the back and I can just choose any color that I want. I usually will grab one from the background, and just for my own purposes, I'm going to turn the line color transparent. Okay, so if I'm working with putting this photo on a background, sometimes adding that frame can give it definition. Okay, and help it pop, especially using white. I used the dark gray. It's actually black, but it came out dark gray on the photo. And I can use that color from the jersey, and it just kind of helps. I can also snag colors from whatever background I'm using, and that helps too. So just depending on what you're working with, that can be a very beneficial tool. Another thing that you can do with framing, let's move that down here. And here, this time I'll show you the offset tool. And sometimes I can get my rounded curves, corners with that too. I'm going to stick with the square corners. And I actually want this to be pretty close to the size of my photo. I'm going to hit apply. And this time I'm going to grab a line color from the photo and I'm just going to thicken it up. So now that can be a way to create another type of frame. But let me show you too what I can do. I can copy and paste and turn it just a little bit and copy and paste again. Maybe turn it just a little more to the other side. And I can arrange these around my photo to give it a more decorative border. Does that make sense? So it's not that, you know, it has to be a perfect border. Sometimes adding these sort of decorative frames can really help too. Now, I've used the heart, I've used a rectangle, you can use squares. There, as a matter of fact, are a lot of decorative frames that you can check out that will add a little bit more flair. But a lot of times, you know, especially when you're working with a photo, you might want to keep the shape of that photo, and just using the same exact outline of the photo to create the frame can be beneficial. So let's move that one out of the way. This is another really cute one. And let me just show you with the circle, a basic circle. So I can just draw the circle wherever I need it to be, or an oval. Let's try again. And then the same thing, I can select these and crop. And I mean, you would just be surprised at how much of a difference it makes being able to incorporate photos in your design when they're not, you know, just blunt square photos. It really makes a big difference in my opinion. Okay, last but not least, I wanted to show you this photo. Again, another photo that the husband took. Okay, fine, you know, I will make do. Now, what I don't like is all of this in the background. Okay, I don't like it at all. And this isn't just a simple case of cropping. So cropping would get out a good portion of it. But let me show you, even if I crop it down, see, it still leaves, unless I'm willing to crop out certain parts of the photo, it still leaves a lot to be desired. So I'm going to introduce you to a free website. Now, this is not a website that I'm affiliated with in any way. It is simply remove.bg. Okay, very simple. It's 100% free. I've used it for a while. It works really well. Also, if you have a subscription to Canva, you can also do the same thing in Canva. But in case you don't, you can do it here. So you can see I was already kind of playing with it, but let me show you where I started. Now, this doesn't work for every single photo, all right? But it has worked for a lot of photos, okay? A lot of photos that I've used. So what I want to do, this is my original photo, and I'm going to choose remove background. And that is literally what it does. Now, let's talk about some flaws in the photo. You can see that it picked up some weird things going on with his hair. It picked up this little stray piece here, and then also between the hat and his arm. So what we can do is, let me see. Oh, we have to click edit first. So click edit, and then you can zoom in. And then after you zoom in, you can come over here and choose the erase and restore. So erase is just like it sounds. Now here's the standard brush size. You can also make that larger or smaller. So I can just click on that to remove it. And then I can come in with a smaller brush size and get these more detailed areas. If I make a mistake and erase too much, I can undo. And trust me, that happens all the time. At least it does with me. Now, obviously, it's not a perfect answer, okay? Like, you know, there are going to be some things that either you can't erase or maybe your freehand erasing aren't going to be stellar, like mine, evidently. Evidently, mine just aren't going to come together. But you can get it, what I'm going to say, good enough, okay? And, I mean, maybe you'll have better luck than I do with this. And while it works really well, you know, like I said, it's one of those things that, depending on your photo, coming in here and touching up these areas can be very time-consuming. As a matter of fact, if he would just cut his hair, I probably wouldn't have to worry about this at all. Just kidding, just kidding. Okay, let's zoom back out. Let's see what we got. So for the most part, I think that turned out a lot better. Now, I keep talking about removing things from the background, but it could just be that you want a standalone photo, and that's okay too. So after you get done, you can just hit download and see where it pops up down here. It's just going to download that straight to my downloads folder. So let's take a look at bringing that into Silhouette Studio. So I can just do the same thing. I'm going to drag and drop. And it has removed my background. So just to compare them side to side, hopefully you can really see the difference here. I mean, I feel like it makes a big difference. If for some reason I felt like I really needed to have a background behind it, I could draw a box and, you know, and add a white background maybe. I could add color if I wanted to. Let's just take a look at what that looks like. I fill that in with white and send to the back. So is it ideal? Probably not. But I mean, it is a very viable solution. And like I said, there's actually a world of things and reasons why you would want to remove the background of the photo, because it just really can make a big difference in whatever project you're working on. So now let's take a look. Now that we have modified these, let's get rid of the ones I don't want to play with. Let's go ahead and take a look at how they work with an actual project. This time I'm going to work with a 20 ounce tumbler. So let's bring that template over. Now I really, really love this one. And this is perfect for sublimation. It's already sized to fit the 20 ounce skinny tumblers. And what I can do now, of course, I'm not saying that you can't mix and match these. You can. And you can even, you know, come up with a way to mix this in with your design. Here, let's send that to the back so it's behind my photos. But you can arrange these in whatever way you see fit, okay? The only thing you need to make sure of is when you butt images up against the side or designs up against the side, you'll just have to remember that this side is in fact going to connect with this side here. So let's move that one out of the way. Let's just place some of these photos and you can see the difference that having the shapes make. Actually, for this template, it would be really awesome to put them all in flowers and do little flowers that mix in. All right, so let's zoom in. And what I wanted to show you now, this one in particular, let's do some editing because I sized it down. So we need to size down the line thickness, okay? Okay, there we go. But I want you to take a look at these three examples. All right, we have one, although it's been cropped, we have one here that has no background, no division. We have one that is on a solid matted background. Okay, I did change it to white. And then this one that has the decorative background. Now, I'm not saying that there's a right or wrong way, but I am saying that there's a definite difference between these three. And it'll just depend on the look that you're going for on which one that you want to choose for your project. Now, I do have a couple more tricks up my sleeve. Now, what I'm going to bring in is a bleach circle, okay? Now, I do have a tutorial on using the bleach circles, and I'm not typically a fan of using them in Silhouette Studio, but for this case, I feel like not only is it really useful for working with photos, but the edges aren't going to make as big of a difference. So if you've watched my bleach tutorial, then that will make a little bit more sense. If you haven't, that's okay, because you can always check it out. And guys, of course, I just want to remind you throughout the video that if you enjoy the video and you feel like you're learning a few things, definitely make sure you subscribe to the channel. All right, there's a cute little button down there that makes it really super easy. Now, this will take you a little bit of time to work with, because do you see all the detail around the bleach circle? All right, that all those details are picked up by Silhouette Studio, so they make it a little harder, or they're a little bit more demanding to be able to size it and move it around. So just make sure you give that some consideration. I'm going to change the line color to transparent, because what you're seeing with all these red dots, that's actually just the line color of all the different pieces. So let's go ahead and center it, and then let's center our template. Okay, so, you know, while it's not ideal to use the bleach circles in Silhouette Studio, you have to admit that there's a little bit to be desired about being able to fade out the edges of your photo. What I mean by that is, not only is this really cute to be able to add whatever photo you're working with, here, let's bring that to the front. Okay, this can serve as a frame of sorts, okay? But what I really want to show you, let's bring in a new picture, because I really do like this one. It's just so super cute. So with this photo, let's size it down just a tad, and let's bring this to the front. I'm going to change the fill color to transparent and the line color to any color I want. It doesn't matter. We can change it back to red. Now I'm going to size my photo, because you saw how it slows your computer down when you are trying to resize the actual bleach effect. So what I'll do is I'll size my photo appropriately, and then if I need to resize my bleach effect, I can do that. So I can put their cute little faces, and just like I would with any other image, I can select these two. I gotta get, you know, deselect my template here, but I can select these two, come over to my modify panel, and crop. Now I'm using the bleach circle as an example, but there are actually quite a few distressed type images that you can use to accomplish the same thing. Now, of course, we do have a tutorial on using distressed images or distressed templates to be able to distress your images and whatnot. But I think this is a really neat way to, you know, take advantage of those types of frames if you're really trying to kind of blend in your photos and make it to where they're not such a blunt edge around the outside. So once the cropping is completed, you can change your line color back to transparent, and then make sure that you group everything together. And there we go. Now it's just a smoother edge to the photo. So, you know, it's not like a miracle worker necessarily, but it definitely smooths out that edge to where it's just not a straight line. Now, you know, I am talking about using these photos for sublimation, mainly because, like, this one in particular is not one I would ever use for a cut file. All right, if I'm going to do this for a cut file, maybe for print and cut vinyl, or, you know, a printable heat transfer, then I would definitely stick with, you know, one of the other methods. You could even do that with something like this, where we remove the background, as long as it had nice smooth lines, more or less. All right. But for the most part, we have some really awesome tools here to be able to work with photos, whether we're working with sublimation or cut files. So let's just position these around so you guys can see in one place all the different options that are available. And, you know, and I'm sure, guys, I'm sure I have just breached the surface. You know, there really are just so many tools that you can use for this type of thing. But, you know, definitely thinking outside the box will help to, you know, just kind of make things go a little smoother. Does that make sense? It won't be so frustrating trying to figure out how to work these designs into your projects. But I would say that if you're going to use, you know, one style, then I would probably stick with that style throughout the entire design, because you can take a look at this one and tell that, like, it doesn't really have that cohesive feel. So if I were going to, you know, distress the photos around the outside, even if I chose different distressed frames, I would definitely, distress them all. Or if I wanted to do different shapes, I could do different shapes. If I wanted to take out the background, I could. And definitely the frames. If I wanted to be able to, give them all a similar feel, I would choose one frame and use that for all the photos. But for the most part, guys, this is the overview of new and creative ways to be able to use photos with your designs.
So guys, how do you feel now about using photos with your sublimation designs? Now I know a lot of times slapping a photo on there can really feel like, you're just putting a block in the middle of your design, and hopefully this will help you a little bit and show you some really neat options for using those photos. Now, of course, if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave that down below. I do love hearing from you guys. I love all the support that you show for the channel. Make sure you subscribe, okay? Very important. And guys, I just really appreciate every time you stop by. I really love hearing, your input on the videos and your special requests, so make sure you get those in. But guys, I'm going to wrap it up for today, but we'll see you again next time.